Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of After Work, Japan Business Time with
Rochelle Karp
from Japan Intercultural Consulting. And this week we have a topic from Dan Skusser, again, asking another great question about what is the perception around requesting, what are the sensitivities about internal transfers
right.
within companies? And this is a really good topic, actually.
Yes.
Hang around. Okay, so we've talked in the past about this whole thing about, at least with Seishain anyway,
right.
The idea that they get rotated through the company and all the departments and they make generalists.
Right.
So there's probably a perception that internal transfers happen all the time. But I think Dan's asking about a thing where you actually request the transfer.
Right, yes. You know, and some companies have the ability to do that.
Yeah.
I see it a lot in the U.S., but some companies in Japan do that. It's sort of an open call for people to apply to a certain position. And it might be one that people might be particularly interested in
yeah.
some way.
Yeah.
And what I found for Japanese is that there's a lot of sensitivity around that. That if you apply for this internal transfer and you don't discuss it with your boss first, and
yeah.
your boss is Japanese, they might feel betrayed.
Yeah. Although, is that a unique to Japan thing?
Yeah, that's a good question. I think it would be appropriate in other cultures as well to
yeah.
give a heads up.
Yeah.
But I think for Japanese, it goes a little bit farther.
When they've gone and spent a few nights in places like this and opened up about their deepest, darkest fears
right.
and so on, I can understand there might be a bit more of a sense. And you know what? Now that you said, I'm just thinking, yeah, if you're at a rugby club and one day you decide you want to play soccer, that even that sort of thing, when you're in a club or any sort of the groups here
right.
are tight. And,
yes.
and if you're like me, a foreigner like me who likes to flip around and try lots of different things, it's pretty deeply frowned upon, actually. And the sensitivity
yes.
just goes up so many notches
right,
when you're in a Japanese company.
Well, it's all the whole Ishinoe Sannen.
Yes.
Yes, that you're expected to stick with things for a long time.
Yeah, right? Yeah. It's definitely true where I am that internal roles and transfers are frequently advertised and they are very sensitive.
Mm-hmm.
There's a perception that the other department is poaching people and there's cross-departmental politics and resentment which can
mm-hmm.
happen
mm-hmm.
As well as for the people and trying to keep people away. The other thing that happens is that sometimes there'll be, Mr. Taro over here is not working out and we'd really love to get a new headcount, but we don't. But if he goes to this new job, we can get a free headcount. So sometimes there is the transfer. That's more of the kind of forced transfer thing.
Mm.
But when someone who's considered a rising star on a team puts their hand up to go to another team, other people will shut down. I can speak from a personal experience. When I got my legal qualification, and I did that partly because I felt like my role was a bit stagnant.
Uh-huh.
It was a great role, but I just realized I'm going to be here 20 years and it's going to be the same thing.
Uh-huh.
And so I got my bar qualification, level one Japanese. I went to the boss. I said, I'd really like to get transferred to the legal department. This was without any consultation with anyone else. I went to my boss first
uh-huh.
to ask him if he'd support me on this. And not only did he reject my request, but he clearly was kind of offended isn't the right word.
Perplexed?
No, I wasn't perplexed. He was
annoyed.
He was annoyed by it. He was kind of like, and it was clearly, for me, it sounded like I'm showing ambition, I'm showing initiative, I'm showing, come up, but it was kind of like I'd done something bad by even having this conversation.
Well, but also it could have been perceived as something bad by you actually had extra time and energy left over from your work to go get a degree. I've had so many Japanese who are working on evening degrees
yeah.
tell me, don't tell the company
oh,
I'm
yeah.
doing this, yes. So he was probably just thinking, wow, well, you're just really disloyal and you're getting some qualification just for yourself rather than putting 110% of your effort into the company.
But, yeah, I feel like, but I was asking for an internal transfer. I wasn't looking for a job outside.
Right, right.
And you know what my boss said to me? He started to get a bit, he was showing a bit, well, he said, there's no one else in the company who can do your role. I can't authorize a transfer for you because who's going to do your job?
Uh-huh.
We couldn't possibly allow you to ever do a different job ever again.
Oh, no.
And he said, and he actually threw in, well, you've got the international qualification. Why don't you just go to a law firm? Which I did.
There you go.
And I must admit, I came back a little bit passively aggressively about this. I thought about what you told me, boss, and he didn't take that very well either.
Well, sounds like probably a good idea you moved on from that one.
I really loved that job, but for myself, I felt like I needed to advance and grow, and I offered myself my services to the company in a different capacity.
And it just doesn't work, yeah.
But it just doesn't work. There's kind of like, it was a kind of a betrayal. It was like I'd gone to a girlfriend and said, hey, I'd really like to have an open relationship. You know? Yeah. That was the kind of reaction that I got.
Yeah.
You know, surely we should be able to just see other people, you know. So, no, it was like even broaching the conversation did definitely affect the relationship.
Yeah, I could see that. Yeah, so you have to be careful. So, in other words, the answer to this question is be careful. It's fraught with pitfalls.
Yeah. Yeah, don't assume everyone's going to be supportive. And I think be aware that there might be some politics to negotiate. And,
right.
And do a lot of consultations and pick who you consult with. Right. So I'd say if there's a role being advertised, go and talk to the people with the role first. Tell them that you're interested. Mm-hmm. And then ask them, because they'll be as sensitive as you are at the idea of being poached. So say, how do we go about this? And how are we going to socialize this? How are we going to create the situation where this will come up? And I've seen staged situations for this. Be really careful. So this is a great topic. Thank you, Dan Skusser.
Yes, thank you.
We're going to be back next week with more stuff about working in Japanese companies.
Yes.
So hang around for another episode of After Work, Japan Business Time with
Rochelle Kopp.
And see you next week.